So the greatest impact that honeybees have is not the products that they produce. It's swamped by comparison by their contributions in their ecosystem services to greater agriculture by performing that pollination services so that all of these different fruits and vegetables that are grown can be of marketable quality and value. You know, a third of everything we eat is really because of pollination by bees, and especially honeybees. So honeybees, they were brought over by the earliest European settlers. They're managed by people, and they're the workhorses for pollination in commercial production agriculture. But native bees, something like 460 native bees that are indigenous to North Carolina, they are wild living, and so they are much more responsive to any changes in the environment. The daily life of a honeybee colony is, first and foremost, you have a single queen. Her only chore is to lay the eggs and to keep the colony going. There are males within the honeybee colony. They're called drones. Their only purpose is to fly from the hive and mate with queens from other colonies. And then finally, the vast majority of a colony's population are the workers. They're all female. And the workers are the ones that do all the work and none of the reproduction. There's a lot of misinformation out there about the state of the bee populations. Those native bees are declining because they are sensitive to environmental changes and all of the threats that are out there, landscape loss, deforestation, pesticides and other things like that. Honeybees, however, because they're semi-domesticated by beekeepers, their losses every single year are averaging around 40%, but then they're able to grow them back. So their population is more fluctuating rather than continuously diminishing. And so honeybees are not at risk of going extinct, but we do need to come up with better means to keep them sustainably. Apiculture program at NC State is comprised of three main areas: research, extension, and teaching. And so in research, we're testing hypotheses about bee biology and management in order to try to understand how beekeepers can better manage their colonies and make it a more sustainable beekeeping population. For the extension, we work very closely with the beekeepers within the state and beyond. North Carolina has the most beekeepers in any other state in the nation, with over an estimated 15,000 beekeepers and nearly 5,000 within their state organization. There's ample opportunity for education and training for beekeepers to keep the population healthy. The third area is academics or teaching, where we teach several courses at NC State for credit, where students really get exposed to the importance of honeybees, both as a connection to agriculture, but also to greater society. So things that everybody can do to really help all bees, honeybees and native bees, is to minimize the use of pesticides in your yard and in your environment. A second thing to do is to plant or to foster landscape that can be conducive to all bees. Things that are pollen and nectar bearing. And then finally, helping researchers, regulatory officials, and others in trying to promote the health and welfare of managed bees and solitary bees. All of these things together will really help.